welcome to another round of Talkin' Shop. Last week, I had my buddy Joe Kolb with me here. This time, it's just me. I didn't have anybody coming through town to chat this up with me. But I wanted to touch base on something I tweeted out last week and meant to do this video sooner, but honestly didn't have the time. So finally getting around to it. But I want to talk about Focus Financial going public this summer and what I think is the maybe new conflict of interest that comes to the table because of this, and just kind of want to get all of your thoughts out there and we can kind of have a dialogue through the comments. But just real quick, if you don't know, Focus Financial went public towards the end of July, raised $500 million, $500 million, with the goal of going out and acquiring up to 500 smaller RIA firms to build this growth out. So far, Wall Street likes what it sees. I think I looked at it a little bit ago, it was up about 20% or so since it IPO'd. And I don't really want to spend a lot of time on Focus's model. This is not a negative video against Focus because honestly, I don't know anybody there. I don't know much about them, their culture. It's more about a conversation about what happens when RIAs start to go to the public market to get funding and now have Wall Street to answer to. Is that a bad thing or a good thing? So the question I'm putting out there, and if I had somebody here I would talk with, is does an RIA being subject to Wall Street's quarterly earnings, guidance, expectations, does that bring a new level of conflict to the table? So we talk a lot about sales conflicts and commissions and all of that, but what about answering to Wall Street and what that means to a firm? So here's my take. I wanna hear yours in the comments below, but my take is I think it does, but I think it's remain yet to be seen whether or not that conflict amounts to be a negative. So, you know, we think of conflicts and automatically we think bad. And just because that conflict is there, it doesn't necessarily mean that it leads to bad things. It's just a conflict. So it's too early in the game to know whether or not this conflict leads to bad practices, bad investor experiences, or whatever it might be. But I am a little concerned about what it might mean for these smaller IRAs. So I would take a step back, and there's always an incentive for a firm to grow and to make recommendations of bringing assets onto the firm when maybe it's not in the client's best interest. So that is always there. I'm not gonna say that as an RIA owner, I don't have that same conflict with my clients. They may have a good 401k at Vanguard, and because I charge a management fee, I'm incentivized by a higher fee by having them roll that to me when they could just be just as good at Vanguard. Can I provide more value than it just being at Vanguard? So that conflict is always there, but I only have to answer to myself as the RIA owner. And I'm in control of the culture of my company as this firm grows so that I can make sure that my advisors that might be working with me are doing what's best for the clients all the time. And if we have a goal in mind for growth that we want to hit, a revenue number, whatever it might be that we're using as a metric, if we miss that, we only have to answer to ourselves. So if I have a goal for growth and I don't hit it, yeah, I might be bummed, but I don't have to answer anybody other than myself. There's nobody else that I have to explain that to. I regroup, set new goals, and move forward. There's nobody banking on me hitting that goal so that they get a bonus or so that they make more money in the markets. And I think that's where the potential for conflict comes. So my concern for these RAs that get acquired through this process is that they're gonna be provided a goal of revenue or acquisition, new accounts, whatever it might be, by Focus Financial, so that Focus Financial can report to Wall Street that they're growing. And I don't think that this will be an issue right now. While the markets are doing well, we see account balances going up, everybody's feeling good. I think that the revenues will probably take care of themselves just on market growth alone. But what happens when that recession comes? What happens when clients are losing money, they're getting scared, they're changing firms? What happens then as far as revenues when going to Wall Street and missing those expectations? I don't really have concerns about short sellers hopping on Focus Financial and driving the stock price down so that it fails, and what does it mean to the clients? I just kind of worry about or wonder what's going to happen to the firms. Are they going to have pressure to hit those numbers? And does an RIA become to look more like the wirehouses and the brokerage firms that get badmouthed a lot, rightfully so, but look more like that environment where we have numbers to hit so that we have that to report to Wall Street. So again, I don't know anybody at Focus. I don't know their firm very much about them other than this article that Michael Kitsis shared. So I'm coming at this not as a company specific, but as a general idea and is this something we're gonna see more and more of, is RIAs going to public markets to be able to grow. I hope I'm wrong. I hope that focus knocks it out of the park. They're able to allow their firms that they acquire to maintain their culture, run things the way they want to, and everything goes well. And this is just a concern that never comes to fruition. But if you think that Wall Street doesn't bring pressures to firms, we only need that, you know, that private firms don't have, we only need to look to the Wells Fargo's and all the scandals they've had, or Merrill Lynch and Bank of America bringing commissions back to retirement accounts after they said they weren't going to do them anymore, mainly because it helps generate revenue. It's higher bumps of revenue today versus the long game of management fees and actually doing financial planning. So there's plenty of examples. AIG, the risks that they took that led to them having to take a bailout during the financial crisis. Now granted, Focus is probably not going to be getting into swaps and all of that type of business, but AIG went that route to boost their revenue, to have better earnings. The higher ups get compensated in stock. I just think that it might bring a little bit of a tainted reputation to the table if this continues to go that way. So like I said, I'm curious to know what you think. I don't sit here on my high horse and say that my firm is not subject to its own conflicts, because all RIAs are. This is not meant to be a negative comment towards Focus or any firms that might do this in the future. Just a conversation piece. What do you guys think? As a client, what do you think about your firm having to answer to Wall Street? Does that make you feel nervous? You may have a great advisor who's always done right by you, but now his firm is owned by a bigger company that reports to Wall Street. What do you think about that? Is that something you're comfortable with, or are you ready to wait and see what might happen in the future? As an advisor, how do you feel about potentially having sales goals in a different aspect when you've been on the independent side of the world that's supposed to be more, not conflict-free, but less conflict, and now you have these goals that might be put in front of you? And maybe these goals never come. I will admit that. I'm speaking ahead of what's going to happen, but what if? How do you feel about that? What does that mean to you and the way that you do business? Like I said, share in the comments. I would love to have an open dialogue, and let's keep these comments clean. Let's keep them nice. There's no reason to be hateful here. Let's be constructive with what we say and have dialogues and not come at people, because this is what we like to do on FinTwit and Finance. We like to take our sides and entrench in and kind of get nasty sometimes. That's not what I want through this. I just want to have a conversation and see if maybe there's something that about this that I don't know, and this is a learning experience for me. I'll tell you right now, this is not a direction that I see myself going. I've had my eyes open to maybe be growing my firm bigger than what I originally said I wanted to. Downtown Josh Brown tweeted at me, grow or die, and it's kind of opened my eyes and maybe thinking about the future. So I don't have any ill will or any issues with Focus wanting to grow. I just don't know if Wall Street's the best way to grow, or are we better off on the independent side that's supposed to be the side of the business that's trying to do the best for clients? Are we better growing organically and structuring deals the old way rather than raising funds? So what do you think? Drop it in the comments. You can do your comments on YouTube. If you're watching this on LinkedIn, put it in the comments on LinkedIn. Facebook, same thing. But let's keep them clean and have a good dialogue out there. Like I said, I hope to do more of these talking shops with more people, more advisors, so it's not just my view, but it was something that I wanted to talk about and put out there. So I appreciate you watching, and I'll see you in the next video.